Mr. Motonobu Hori and Shinichiro Watanabe. Well, gentlemen, welcome to London. How has your trip been so far?
Such
an amazing city, loads to see, so I've been enjoying it a lot.
僕はロンドンに来てまだレコード屋さんにしか行ってないので他のところは分かりません。
I've only been to the vinyl shops actually so far, so I don't actually know the rest.
Is it fair to say that your trip here today to London may have, your attire may be influenced by the fact you are here in London?
このロンドン滞在でこちらのお衣装を選ばれたんですか？ということですか？
ロンドンのコスプレをしてきました。
Yes, I cosplayed with the theme of London.
There you go.
もちろん僕のノースフェイスもロンドン風にしてきました。
Yes, of course, my North Face parka, as you can see, is very London as well.
Totally.
すいません、嘘です。
Okay, sorry, it's a lie.
How would you describe the story of Carol and Tuesday?
Tuesday のお話、ご説明いただけますか？話、ストーリーのご説明をいただけますか？見たことがない人に対して。
キャロル&チューズデイは、2人の女の子、全く、何者でもない2人の女の子がミュージシャンになるまでの話です。
キャロル&チューズデイ is a story of two girls、who are not professionals, but it's a story of them becoming musicians.
音楽もののアニメなんですけど、他の音楽もののアニメと違うのはものすごく音楽に力を入れているということです。
So it is an anime based on music、but the difference with the rest of music anime is that we really dedicated ourselves in creating good music.
僕はすごく長い間の、long time music freak なんで、すごく、お金もかけて時間もかけて、いい音楽を作った自信がありますと。
So I've been a music freak for a long time. So I can confirm that I have dedicated myself in creating good music with lots of investment in time and cost as well.
この作品には世界中からいろいろなミュージシャンが参加しています。
For this anime, many of the musicians worldwide have participated, collaborated.
そしてイギリスからも4人のミュージシャンが参加しています。
And we had four brilliant British musicians contributed to this.
When it comes to artificial AI, is it fair to say that that was an influence on you when it came to the creation of this series?
そうですね。僕は昔マクロスプラスというアニメを作りまして、その作品でも AI が歌を歌ってました。
Yes, I made an animation called Macross Plus before, and yes, we did have AI musician within it as well.
その時は、まだ AI が歌を歌うっていうのは僕たちの空想の産物だったんですけど、今ではもう初音ミクがどんどん歌を歌うようになってしまいました。
Back then, AI becoming a musician was completely in imagination. It didn't exist at all. But 初音ミク became a reality now.
それでまた同じことをやっても現実に追い抜かれてしまうので、今回の作品の AI ではもっと AI が人間、進化して人間に近くなっているというふうにしています。
So if we were to just follow the same theme, the reality would just exceed us eventually. So we decided that AI is something that is evolving and constantly would evolve. And that evolution took AI to the stage of almost similar to the humans.
作曲をしたりもしますし、歌も歌いますし、まあ、あとはすごく人間に近づいた結果、人間に信用できる人も信用できない人もいるように、AI にも信用できる AI も信用できない AI もいると。
So AIs would reach a level of like, you know, themselves composing and singing, performing, but the characteristics of them become more apparent as well. So when we think of human beings, there are trustworthy and like not so trustworthy humans, and the same thing could be seen in AIs too.
嘘をついたり、あと怠けてビールばっかり飲んでると、そういう AI も出てきます。
There are lying AIs or also slacker AIs as well who wouldn't work and just keep drinking beer, for example.
それは進化した結果そういうふうに AI がなったというような見せ方を今回してます。
But we decided that's a form of representation of showing that AI, that's a sign of evolution of the AI.
Can you expand on what each of your roles are in this particular series?
その翻訳の時に僕スーパーバイジングディレクターとかいうふうに書かれちゃうんですけど、実際は2人で共同でコーディレクターとして作業してます。
Yes, when the title's credits were translated into English, they decided to name me as supervising director and Hori-san as director. But really, it's essentially a co-directing project.
基本的にストーリーとか、スクリーンプレイとか、ストーリーボードの方は僕の方で作業して、その後の全ての大変な絵を作る作業は Hori-san の方に任せています。
So the scripting of the screenplay and also the storyboard is made by me and mostly, but everything else that is that works that is more meaty is taken on by Hori-san.
そうですね。やっぱり若い時からアニメーターになる前からやっぱり渡辺さんのことは知ってましたし、ファンだったので、やっぱりまずそれ渡辺さんと一緒に働けるということ自体がまずすごく光栄なことっていうのは一つあります。
So when I was younger, even before becoming an animator, I was a fan of Watanabe-san. So it was a great honor to be able to collaborate with Watanabe-san.
To add an extra question to that, do you recall what the first project of Watanabe-san's that you saw was?
Macross Plus とやっぱカウボーイビバップですかね。
Yes, it was Macross Plus and also Cowboy Bebop as well.
When it comes to talent shows, are you both a fan of them?
オーディション番組お好きですか、お二人は。オーディション番組。
キャロル&チューズデイが、デビューしようとしてオーディション番組に出るというシチュエーションが出てきます。
Yes, as you described, the talent show is a big component of the show. Carol and Tuesday try and becoming a musician. They would try out at the talent show.
そのエピソードをリアリティのあるものにするために、僕たちは打ち合わせの時にいつも、あるテレビ番組の映像を見てました。
So to create that episode of them auditioning at the staff meeting, we were watching a certainA TV show that you may recall to add the reality.
It's a X Factor.
You can add that to the list of things you did not expect to hear today during this panel.
その番組から受けた影響が一つあります。
And there was one notable influence that we had from the show.
X Factor ではこのイギリス人の審査員がすごく皮肉に満ちた。この厳しい批評をします。
In X Factor, as you know, one certain British judge is known as extremely critical and very sarcastic.
誰のことを言ってるかはもう分かると思います。
And you probably know who I'm talking about. Don't need to name any names.
その、イギリス人らしい皮肉の言い方を参考にして作りました。
And I based on the comments from the judges with his.Sarcastic ways and also artistic ways of criticizing.
それはでも僕たちがイギリス人っぽいと思ってるだけかもしれません。
But those comments seem extremely British, but maybe that's us, maybe that's the way that we perceive them.
誤解だったらすいません。
Sorry, it's a misunderstanding on our part, really.
What would you do on the show?
何を歌われますか？何をされますか？オーディション番組。オーディション番組に出るとしたら何をされますか？
Me?
Yes. It could be anything.
Hori-san?
London Calling を歌いますかね。
I might sing London Calling, maybe.
Yes! Bit of the Clash, I'm up for that.
Clash いいですね。
僕はじゃあちょっとダンスを披露すると思います。
In that case, I'm gonna dance.
So, to expand on that,
そこから広げたいと思うんですけども。
Is there a particular music you would dance to?
なんかそのダンスに合わせるって踊る曲は何ですか？
あのこの本編でさっき最初に出ていた Dance Tonight って曲がありまして、これは僕すごく気に入っている曲なんで、これで踊りたいと思います。
So there was a song that we showed called Dance Tonight, and it's one of my favorites, so I think I'm going to dance to that.
そんなに広げなくていいと思うんですけど、このままだと僕がここ本当にここで踊る羽目になっちゃうんで。
Let's not expand any further because I feel like the next question might be, so why don't you try it?
キャラクターが本当に歌っているように、もしくは演奏しているように、見える必要があると思ってました。
For this work, I thought it was very important that characters looked like they were singing themselves or playing the instruments themselves.
それでまず、実際に曲を、演奏できる人に演奏してもらいました。
So we asked the musicians to play the instruments and also sing in reality.
でまずそれが一つ、これがその映像です。
And this is one of the examples.
ライブアクションの A を先に撮ってるって。
So we video the live action first.
そして、この作品では楽器、ギターだったりとか、キーボードだったりとかは 3D の CG で作っています。
Mm-hmm. And in this work, we have used the CG to write the guitars and keyboards.
でこの、実写の映像を参考にまず3D の、モーションをつけます。
And so based on this video, we did the motion capture on this instrument first.
でもこれが意外とですね、やっぱ上手な人がやらないと、いくらこう実写の参考があっても、やっぱ動きを上手に拾えたりとか、あとアニメ的にいい動きにならないんですね。Mm-hmm.
And it really asks the skills of the animators because even though it's based on the video, you need to follow it very delicately. Otherwise, it just doesn't look realistic when they're moving.
あとこれ僕も何年も前にアニメーターになった時に初めて驚いたんですけども、結構絵がですね、一枚一枚意外とイラストみたいにかなり丁寧に描いてあるんですよね。Mm-hmm.
And I was quite surprised when I first became an animator as well. But all these shots are very detailed. It's almost like illustration in themselves.
で、こちらを、最終的に、清書して色をつけたものが次になります。
And so, and we would finalize this and then color it in, which is the next step.
つまり、ライブアクションとハンドドローイングと 3D の全部ハイブリッドで、mm-hmm.作られているってことです。
So in essence, this anime is made by live actions, 3D, and also hand drawing anime. So it's a hybrid of the three.
どうして全部 3D にしないのかって言いますと、やっぱり全部 3D にしてしまうとすごい人形みたいな感じに見えてしまうんで、そこは手で描いた方がやっぱりキャラクターとしては。クオリティが上がるいい感じになるので、ハンドドローイングを基本にしています。
The reason why we didn't make this anime in full CG 3D is because characters when they're made with like 3D, it just doesn't look realistic. They just look like dolls almost. So to add the realism, we decided to stick to hand drawing.
そういうのも全部ライブアクションでダンサーに踊ってもらったものを撮影して。それを元にアニメーターが描いてます。
And dance is the same as well. We asked the dancers to dance first. We recorded it, and then that is being turned into animation afterwards.
だいたい今こんな感じですね。
Yes. So that is the process, briefly.
そうですね。渡辺さんがやっぱりこうやりたい要求されるクオリティが非常に高いので、非常に苦労しました。
Yes, it has been a challenge because the quality Watanabe-san asks us is extremely high. So the bar has been set very high. So yes, it was a challenge, definitely.
Making Carol on Tuesday with music being a massive motivation behind it, were there any specific genres you wanted to explore more than others?
ジャンルを広げたいとかアメリカのシンガーソングライターのジェーン・ウッドっていう人がいまして、この人の曲に僕すごくインスパイアされて作ったので、で実際キャロル&チューズデイの曲も彼女が2曲作ってるんですけど、ジェーン・ウッドの曲はぜひ皆さん聴いてみてくださいと。
It's not really specific to any genres, but I am very inspired by a US singer called Jane Wood. And she contributed two songs as well. And her, she's amazing, so I highly recommend her, listen to her songs.
The inspiration for the song Galactic Mermaid.
Thank you very much. Sorry about that.
Galactic Moment の inspiration はどこから得たんですか?
さっきもインタビューで同じことを聞かれました。
I was asked that in an interview earlier as well, the same question.
Inspiration?日々心の中でいろんなことに対してこのコンチクショーと思う気持ちがこの曲を生んだんだと思いますと。
Every day, just living in this world, you know, there are moments that you kind of want to say, damn it! And those kind of like accumulations probably, probably resulted in this song.
それがインスピレーション。
That's my inspiration for this song.
Carol and Tuesday is a very political show and an optimistic show, but there are a lot of people who don't feel that optimistic about the state of the world today, so I was wondering if you had anything you wanted to say to people who feel that way.
前向きになれない人に対してのアドバイスをいただけますか? なんか
Very good question, by the way.
いいことがないとないのが前提だと思う。
For those who find it hard to be positive or like, you know, be very kind of like forward looking, just take it as a given that there are no good things.
まあ、っていうのが僕がアニメーターをやってて学んだことです。
And that's something I've learned as an animator.
That is a fantastic quote right there.
でも、まあ、今回来れたのがすごく良かったんで、まあ、たまにはいいことがあるなって。
But just me being here, being invited to talk, that's a good thing. So there are good things eventually if you keep plowing through.
イギリスでずっと毎日天気が悪いのがデフォルトっていうのと同じだと思います。
It's probably the same as British weather, really. You know, like it's a default setting that we don't have good weather here.
たまに晴れになるとすごくいい気持ちになると。
So, but just by having that bad weather, one sunny day makes it worthwhile, doesn't it?
Yeah, totally.
キャロル&チューズデイ本当にすごく力を入れて作った作品なんで、あとは本当にまあイギリスだけじゃなくて、フランスとかポルトガルとかいろいろなところからもミュージシャンが参加していますので、で本当に曲はいい自信がある作品なんで、音楽を聴くためだけにも見た方がいいと思います。
Karen Tuesday, we really, really put all our energies into it, effort into it, and so I hope you enjoy it. There are many musicians who contributed to this, not only British but French and like, you know, those based in Portugal as well. So I really recommend you watch it, actually.
今回作業してみて、自分でもこう音楽とアニメーションが合わさるとすごくいい効果が出るというのをすごく自分でも実感して、はい、自分でも見ててすごく感動したんで、すごくおすすめします。
And the more I worked on this, I realized the synergy between music and animation and how well they go together. So it really moved me. So I highly recommend it that you watch it.
Does Mr. Watanabe have any comments about the upcoming live-action Cowboy Bebop? Does he have any feelings about it? And does he have any input into the development of it?
That didn't take long to ask that question, did it? So, any feelings on the live-action Cowboy Bebop that you can share?
I've been so busy with this project Carol and Tuesday, so I'm not really involved with live action of Cowboy Bebop. But I've heard it in the grapevine that the main actor is injured, so that's why the filming process is stopped.
でもまだ完成した映像をワンカットも見てないのでどんな風になってるのかわからないですね。
But I haven't seen any finalized scenes at all, so even one cut of it, so I don't really know how it's going.
いい作品になってることを祈りたい。
But I'm praying that it is going well.
How did you come up with the music for Cowboy Bebop and Samurai Champloo?
So how did you come up with the music for Cowboy Bebop and Samurai Champloo?
そうですね。Cowboy Bebop の時はまず宇宙が舞台だったんで、宇宙が舞台で宇宙っぽい例えばシンフォニックな音楽をつけたら。それスターウォーズみたいになっちゃうのでそれを避けました。
So for a Cowboy Bebop, because it was set in space, I first came up with some symphonic orchestral music, and that just turned into something very kind of Star Wars-esque. So I decided to stay away from that.
サムライチャンプルーの時はこれは時代劇っていう江戸時代、すごい古い時代の話なんで逆に一番新しい音楽ジャンル、ヒップホップにしたらいいんじゃないかと。したらそのギャップが面白いと思いました。
And for Samurai Champloo, because it's set in the Edo period, obviously in the ancient times, I thought, why don't I combine it with the contemporary music, very kind of like, on trend music. So we decided to go for hip hop, and that created a very interesting juxtaposition.
だから常に作品との間にギャップがある音楽の方が面白いんじゃないかと思っています。
So I always feel like when there is a slight difference between the music and also the anime themes, that creates an interesting balance when there is a gap between the two.
So how did you come up with the ending for Space Dandy? If you've not seen Space Dandy, potential spoilers, by the way. Warning.
結末について喋ったらネタバレになるんじゃないですか。大丈夫ですか？
You know what? I will. If anyone does not like this decision, I apologize. Come speak to me, but cover your ears for the moment. Yes, let's answer this.
今、大丈夫です。耳をカバーしてもらったので大丈夫
です。SF サイエンスフィクションの世界で最も新しい潮流は、世界は一つじゃなくてたくさん同時に存在、たくさんの世界が存在するというアイデアです。
So in the SF sphere, as many of you may know, one of the new streams is that parallel worlds. There are a few different worlds going on at the same time.
僕はその話を聞いて、世界がたくさんあるのであれば、毎週毎週いろんな、全然違う話をやっても、成り立つんじゃないかと。
And so I just thought if we do exist in a parallel world, then maybe I could repeat different stories every single week, perhaps.
だからそういう、なんていうんですかね、パラレルワールドという概念を悪用して、毎週毎週好き放題な話を作ったっていうことですね。
So I've used the concept of parallel world in a very selfish manner and decided to come up with different stories, episodes every week.
例えば主人公が死んでしまうストーリーもあるんですけど、これは別の世界だから、次の話数では知らん顔でまた生きているというふうな作り方をしています。
For example, a protagonist dies in one of the episodes, but because it's parallel worlds, he could just be revived up for the next week. So that's how we went on.
Our space dandy Carolyn Tuesday and Cowboy Bebop set in the same universe.
Oh!
Their currency is the same, Oolon.
でも、そうですね。それ全部同じ世界なんですけど、それだけじゃなくて、サムライチャンプルーとか他のアニメも全部同じ世界なんです。
So yes, they do exist in the same universe, but all my other animes like Samurai Champloo is within the same universe as well.
でもこれは秘密なんでちょっと黙っといてください。
But this is a secret, so you cannot disclose this information to anybody else.
It's just between us,
yeah.
Right?
ここだけですよね。ここ。
I'm genuinely amazed by that answer.
Any sort of creator, what advice could you give them and how could you have given that advice to yourself?
クリエイターに対するアドバイスはたった一つです。
There is only one advice that I could give to the creators.
Please see Carol on Tuesday. あの実際この作品はクリエイターがどうするべきかという問題を扱っています。
But really, this anime does treat the subject of like what the creators should do. How should they begin?
最初は、クリエイターの人っていうのはみんなこういうのをこういう絵を描きたいとかこういう音楽を作りたいとかすごいそういういい衝動っていうものがあると思います。
I do believe all the creators start from a good impulse point that they want to draw or they want to sing.
でも何年も何年も続けていくうちにだんだんそういう気持ちを忘れてしまいます。
But as the time goes on, after a few years, they tend to forget that impulse, initial impulse.
そして仕事が辛いとかあれがやりたくないとかこれがやりたくないとかそういう不満ばっかり言うようになってしまいます。
And they would start to complain about like how hard their work is. No, I don't want to do this. I don't want to do that. And they would just complain. Just goes on and on and on.
そういう時に最初の気持ちを思い出せと、そういうことですね。
And so I would like to say, go back to where you started. Go back to how you felt in the beginning.
Carol and Tuesday を見てください。
Please watch Carol and Tuesday.
What did you think of the Into the Spider-Verse animation, and is that something you would like to delve into?
They have used so many different techniques, but that didn't just end up as an experiment. It was an entertainment, so I thought it was amazing. If you know any of the staff's contact details, please do pass it over. I'd like to scout them to what come and what.
A couple of years ago, you were approached by Denis Villeneuve for Blade Runner 2049 for one of his short films. And you did a short film based on the Blackout 2022, I believe. What was it like working on that particular film and giving your interpretation of the Blade Runner films and the lore in general?
僕は、最初の Blade Runner の映画はもう all-time favorites の最も好きな映画だったので、すぐ引き受けました。
So I was a big fan of the initial Blade Runner, like it's probably one of my all-time favorite films. So I said yes.
本当はキャロル&チューズデイの仕事がもう始まってたんですけど、これはちょっと横に置いてブレードランナーを先にやりましたと。
Actually, Carol and Tuesday's production was already starting, so I should have been focused on that, but I decided to put that aside and then work on Blade Runner.
でも、ハリウッドの仕事はいつもそうなんですけど、大変プロデューサーがいろいろ口を出してきました。
But this is the case with any Hollywood project. But producers have a lot to say.
毎日プロデューサーと戦ってましたと。
So I was fighting against a certain producer every single day.
それで、もうやらないと思いました。
So my conclusion is I probably won't work on something similar again.
次のブレードランナーのテレビシリーズが発表されていて、そこに、僕一応エグゼクティブプロデューサーでクレジットされてるんですけど、
So, Blade Runner has announced that they are making the TV series and I have been credited as an executive producer within it.
そんなに仕事してません。
But I haven't really worked on it all that much. Really.
シナリオをちょっと遠くからこのぐらいの距離から見て、Oh, pretty good.
It was like, so I reviewed the script from about this much distance and saying, it's not that bad, is it? So like, yeah, okay, that's it.
What impact do you think streaming services such as Netflix is having on the anime industry?
Netflix の、そのストリーミングサービスはアニメ業界にどういう影響を与えていると思いますか? Netflix のような。Netflix のようなストリーミングサービスはアニメ業界にどんな影響を与えていると思われますか？
制作費が増えますよね。
The production costs will go up, I think.
それとあとやっぱり今までまあタイムラグなくいろんな国の人に見てもらえるのはすごくいいですね。
And also one of the benefits is that like we can distribute it worldwide without any time lag.
Anything you would like to add, Mr. Watanabe?
ですね。Netflix で、全世界で放送されるっていうんで、最初から作るときにこれは世界中の人が分かるようにというふうに意識するようになりました。
Because creating for Netflix, because it's worldwide distribution and everybody in the world could see it, that was something in my mind when I started working on this.
Space Dandy も世界中で放送されていたんですけど、同時に。その時はあまり考えてませんでした。
And Space Dandy as well, it was distributed globally too, but at the time that wasn't something that I was mindful of.
そして日本人にしかわからないようなギャグをたくさん入れてました。
And that's why I put in lots of jokes that were only very localized, only Japanese audience would get.
それを反省しまして、今度はちゃんとわかるようにしようと。
But
ということで、キャロル&チューズデイを作りました。
But I learned my lessons from that, so I decided to make it a bit more universally appealing. So, and that's been used in Carol and Tuesday.
Please give a big, big, warm London round of applause for our anime guests of honor, Mr. Motonobu Hori and Shinichiro Watanabe.